The World Health Organization estimates that 58% of disease burden or 8,42,000 deaths per year is attributable to a lack of safe drinking water supply, sanitation and hygiene. So, the supply of safe drinking water is essential for a healthy life. But wait, as common people, how do we know which water is safe for drinking? So, because of the lack of scientific knowledge, we usually use water filters. The most common used water filter these days is the RO water filter, that is, which employs the reverse osmosis. But what if I tell even the water obtained from these RO water filters is not fit for drinking? Yes, this is surprising as well as true, as they are confirmed by the National Green Tribunal as well as the World Health Organization. So in today's discussion, we shall understand what is reverse osmosis, why there is a concern over the use of reverse osmosis waters, what are the issues, and we shall also discuss about the recently released draft notification which essentially bans the use of RO water filters in particular areas and other issues related. So hello guys and welcome back to another lazy lesson. So first of all, what is reverse osmosis? First, let us understand that osmosis is a process where a solvent naturally moves from an area of low solute concentration through a membrane to an area of high solute concentration. But in reverse osmosis, an applied pressure is used to overcome the natural osmotic pressure. It is basically a water purification process that uses a partially permeable membrane to remove ions, unwanted molecules and larger particles from drinking water. This process can remove many types of dissolved and suspended chemical species as well as biological ones such as bacteria from water. And it is used both in industrial processes as well as production of potable water. The result of this process here is that the solute is retained on the pressurized side of the membrane, whereas the pure solvent is allowed to pass to the other side. The process looks neat and good. Then what is the issue with RO water? Well, it is true that the RO process removes unwanted chemicals as well as bacteria. But in the process, some useful minerals are also removed from the water. Various studies have shown that the process can cut the levels of calcium and magnesium in the drinking water. And the second issue here is that in RO, the total dissolved solids, which is called as TDS in water, which cover traces of chemicals, certain viruses, bacteria and salts are reduced. But this process wastes nearly 80% of the water during this treatment. So wastage of the water is the second issue here. And lastly, after analyzing hundreds of scientific studies concerning demineralized or reverse osmosis water, the World Health Organization released a report stating that such water has a definite adverse influence on the animal as well as human organisms. So these are the main issues because of which both NGT as well as WHO are against the use of RO waters. And yet, despite this fact, why do we want to still use various water purifiers or water purification processes? Well, purified water is essential for a healthy and good life. But many cities in India still lack from this basic necessity. This is very well reflected in the water quality report that was released last year by the Bureau of Indian Standards. The study analyzed the quality of piped water being supplied in the country and also ranked the states, smart cities and even districts based on the quality of tap water. Well, the study revealed some of the interesting and amazing facts. Firstly, more than 163 million of Indians, which is higher than the population of whole of Russia, do not have access to the safe drinking water. And next, irrespective of the source of water, in most parts of rural India, availability of water decreases dramatically in the summer months as the water levels drop and the surface sources may dry up. Further, India's estimated per capita availability of water in 2025 will be 1341 cubic meter. This may further fall to 1140 cubic meter in 2050. And also, the Composite Water Management Index of Niti Aayog says that 70% of water supply in the country is contaminated. Besides, India is ranked 120th among 122 countries in Water Quality Index released by an NGO called as Water Aid. And hence, purification of water that we receive is necessary. But consumers have been so concerned with removing as many things from water as possible that they have forgotten to ask if the resulting water actually improves health or causes any health problems. So in this regard, the Union Environment Ministry has recently issued a draft notification which seeks to regulate the use of membrane-based water purification systems. This primarily concerns the manufacturers of reverse osmosis water filters. If you see, the notification is the culmination or an outcome of a legal dispute before the National Green Tribunal, which had banned the RO water filter used in Delhi, as this process wasted much of the water. The notification here mainly deals with rules for commercial suppliers and for integration of systems that inform consumers about TDS levels, a major determinant in water quality. The center here wants to ban the use of RO systems in areas where the source of water meets the Bureau of Indian Standards drinking water norms. As per these norms, if the water has a TDS level of less than 300, it is considered excellent for drinking. Similarly, if it has TDS level above 1200, it is considered unacceptable.